on Nationwide This Evening, a passion for photography in the Midlands. The Clare-based painter, whose work is appreciated in high places like Buckingham Palace.
Michael Hanrahan gave up a career in banking to pursue his passion for painting. He now lives in Ennistymon in County Clare, and Carol Coleman went along to visit him to find out about his life and work.
Clahan, near Lahinch in County Clare, is one of Ireland's most rugged and scenic places. And it's to this inspiring spot that artist Michael Hanrahan returns again and again to paint.
Well, I see the coast, the rocks, the waves. There's a slight wind here today, but sometimes it can be very stormy. But to capture the Atlantic, Wild Atlantic Way, this is my Wild Atlantic Way. My family have been coming here for the last 50 years. I feel very much at home here.
Today, Michael is using acrylics, though he has also painted his favourite scene in oil and watercolour, depending on what he wants to capture.
The sun shining, the sun going down, sunsets, early morning, busy afternoons with lots of people swimming here. I'm thinking of the colour scheme that I'm going to use. I want to get the shape of the rocks. If there's a strong current, if I can get some waves into it, that's important.
And while painting landscapes looks relaxing, getting the scene right requires Michael's total focus.
And after 2 or 3 hours painting, you're exhausted because you're concentrating for every moment, every brush stroke.
Ten years ago, Dubliner Michael relocated from Newbridge, County Kildare, to Ennistymon. The 65-year-old now works from his studio on the main street. A huge change from his former career as a bank manager with AIB. Even with a busy job, marriage and 4 children, Michael painted in his spare time.
And I would go on painting holidays. That was my holiday. I wasn't interested in reading a book. I was interested in doing some painting. I just decided that 38 years working in a financial organisation was enough. I always had a huge interest in painting and art, and I wanted to do it full time. So I came down to Ennistymon, got a studio in the courthouse, started painting, selling paintings, and I just loved it.
Michael is drawn to well-known faces and events. In his studio, we find Olympic champion Katie Taylor throwing a punch, and Christy Moore giving it his all in concert. But Michael's biggest break was getting permission to paint Queen Elizabeth's historic visit to Ireland and President Higgins' return visit to Britain.
3 days before the Queen arrived, the Department of Foreign Affairs sent me an email. They said, we've 1,200 journalists covering the visit and you're going to be the artist. Get up to Dublin and be here for that visit. And I did 10 paintings. The Queen has one, Mary McAleese has another, Princess Anne in London had another, and the rest of them were sold at auction by White's Art Auction House in Dublin.
And in case you're wondering, you don't just post a painting to Buckingham Palace, you deliver it personally.
When I was invited over to Buckingham Palace on the 8th of August 2011, my 3 daughters and my son, Aer Lingus, flew us over with the painting, and we were collected in a Bentley and driven to Buckingham Palace, and we were there all day.
Michael has received many letters from the Queen, as well as one from the Obamas, who accepted a painting of their Irish visit. Another president provided the material for a series commemorating JFK's visit to Ireland in 1963. Michael's work now hangs at the Kennedy Foundation in Boston. While people and places provide the inspiration, galleries like Kenny's are a vital showcase for Clare's artists.
We're located here in Lahinch, County Clare. It's right in the middle of the Wild Atlantic Way. About 6 miles up the road, we have the famous Cliffs of Moher, which is very dramatic scenery. The gallery has been going since 1975 as part of the main shop. And then in 2000, we opened this bigger gallery that you see here. We have artists from all over Ireland and international.
Galleries like Kenny's encourage and support the creative work of artists.
But some artists wouldn't be very good at selling, and they would prefer to hang them in the gallery and then let us sell them and let people come in and see what they like.
As well as the cliffs, artists from around the world are drawn to Clare's Burren with its unique landscape of rocks and underground caves.
For the last 25 years, people coming here are affected by the place. It's not just a pretty place in which, you know, pretty landscape to paint. They're actually, when you expose yourself to it, it actually permeates your being, and it absolutely helps you to be more creative.
Since becoming a full-time painter, Michael Hanrahan has attended workshops at the Burren College of Art to improve his painting skills. And he's not the only artist to have changed direction in later years.
So we're seeing increasingly people who have had their profession as lawyers or bankers or whatever it was, and they're now reaching maybe middle age, and they're saying, what am I really about? What's burning inside me? And they're coming back and maybe taking a workshop to begin with, and then realizing, actually, there's a whole lot of talent in there that's waiting to be expressed.
From the bank to Brazil, Michael's second career has taken him around the world and back. This year he spent 2 months painting in colourful Brazil, and he has a seasonal residency teaching painting to holidaymakers aboard the Cunard cruise lines.
People that I teach watercolour painting, they're in their 60s and 70s, and perhaps they would have painted 40 years ago, but they're now on a cruise line around the world and they want the opportunity of working with an artist. So it's never too late.
It's never too late to start, because, you know, those neurons can be reactivated. Most of the time what it requires is people to get out of their own way and to silence that voice in their heads saying, I'm not very good at this. Just go and forget about what the output's going to be. Just enjoy the process.
As he puts the finishing touches to another painting, Michael Hanrahan is glad he took the leap.
I don't think it can get any better. And I just love doing what I'm doing.
So to any would-be artists who are thinking that perhaps it's too late, think again and give it a go.